From as far back as 1912, plans were being discussed to actually eliminate Denaby Crossing and build a bridge. A report in the South Yorkshire Times of January the 20th that year tells us the same. Moving on to the 1930s, the West Riding County Council announced a 5-year plan which would involve the building of a bridge over Denaby Crossing. Costs at that time were given as £150,000. We were to wait a long time.
Denaby Crossings. 150 yards away from this crossing is the site of Denaby Pottery. In the Doncaster Gazette in 1866 read an advertisement that stated, John Wardle and Co, earthenware manufacturers, stoneware merchants etc, dinner, tea and toilet sets in lustres and gold with a great variety of enamel jugs. Denaby Pottery, Conisbury, near Rotherham. On the 13th of August 2001, Dr. Richard Gregory from the University of Manchester and his team started work removing topsoil on the site of the Denaby Pottery. Many finds were discovered, shards and kiln furniture. The eastern end of the large building was discovered during the excavation, and the building was constructed of mortared sandstone blocks that were possibly quarried from the very site where they stood. The foundations of 3 further buildings with bases and 4 kilns with machine settings were unearthed as well. A large circular base for the bottle kiln was also discovered. The fire bricks at the base of this were made at Swaddling Court, probably shipped down in the canal or on the railway from there. The base of the large chimney stack. A very beautiful enamelled jug with a reclining cupid, peculiar to the Denaby Pottery. Also Albion transfer printed ware, also made at the nearby Dome factory, the same pattern. The site was perfectly situated between the canal, the railway and the colliery, and production must have been very extensive in the 4 years it survived. On the 28th of September 2001 the team wrapped up their excavations, and later on that month Balfour Beatty and their earth moving machines moved in and obliterated the site forever.
And at long last, work commenced. This work is going on the Mexborough side of the bridge. This was termed the North Approach. Topsoil removed and replaced with aggregates. Surveyors were viewing the Denaby Lane and Quicksave area. All important preparatory work. You can see the pegged out stakes there. Minimise disruption of traffic at first. And this is a view of the four Armcore culverts, which had to be extended and strengthened. The purpose of these is for flood diversion should the River Don rise. Remember, this is in the flood plain. You can see how deep the contractors had to extend their works. The level of the road tells you this. Topsoil removed and replaced with aggregates. Amazingly, 87,000 tons of limestone fill had to be used in total. And this was consolidated by rolling and smoothing out. Foundations are everything in an operation of this size. This is the removal of topsoil. This is in the Quicksave area, the South Approach. This is a vertical band machine. It was used for drain making on the North Approach. Very important because the area of work was actually in the flood plain, and at the end of the day the machine rests. Morning comes. And work commences again. Vast quantities of material. These needed to be consolidated by rolling and compacting concrete and cement. You can notice the depth, how far down that the contractors had to go. Balfour Beatty, of course, the main contractors. Queuing all the the way back by the Rearsby Arms, now called the Milestone. And you can see traffic backing up along Hilltop Road. This was the daily problem that the local people had to encounter. Parallel work going on both sides of the operation. Size of the operation was quite impressive. On the 19th of October 2001, fresh pottery shards were discovered. Dr. Gregory had to be sent for to examine these, and work temporarily halted. An extra entrance was cut out for access to the area by the railway and river. South side view again. And Denaby Lane had to be kept open to traffic and also to be kept clean to ensure the surface was clear of all mud and debris. This work was ongoing throughout the work. Some lost patience and decided to take a detour via Pastures Road. This happened over and over again. This is rock breaking on the old pottery site. Soil samples were also taken away for test. The entrance is now complete for site vehicles. Yorkshire Electricity arrived on site for the diversion of the 66 kVA overhead cables. Limestone blocks were installed to protect the river bank. The arrival on site then of this drilling machine and concrete mixer. In total, 3,400 cubic metres of concrete were used on the project. And this is unloading of the bits for the drill. And more equipment was brought in for additional work to the overhead 66 kVA pylons and wires. The South Yorkshire Emergency Services had special protocols to encounter delays at Denaby Crossing. For example, the fire service would turn out appliances from Mexborough and Edlington for incidents in Denaby and Conisborough. The boring drills used were 700 millimetres in diameter. Now we can see the arrival, preparation and finally erection of the boring machine taking place. When emergency ambulances were delayed, we could only really speculate as to the consequences for the patients. The ambulances had to wait along with everyone else. Here we can see drilling beginning on the south side. At the south side, the depth of the bore had to be 12 metres. This was due to the bedrock being found near the surface. However, on the north side, the depth had to be to 18 metres. And the realignment of Denaby Lane moves towards completion. And now the site is prepared on the north bank to receive the drilling machine. See it in action here, down to a depth of 18 metres. This is a pile tester, was put in place once drilling was complete. The entrance to Denaby Lane was permanently closed. The reason for this was is the new road alignment comprises of an embankment. Working with the community at all times, a special exhibition was held at Conisborough Library on the 22nd of November. As work closed up to the railway line, special possession arrangements had to be put in place. All trains were cancelled. And on the 25th of November, night drilling commenced right at the side of the railway line. This work was carried out on a Saturday evening. It's the most quiet time on the railway, so not too many trains would have to be cancelled or diverted. And when the following Sunday morning arrived, the drill had to be moved away from the railway to restore traffic. And this is the concrete fill for the causeway area. Underground ducts, electricity, etc. had to be diverted. During the winter of 2002, the River Don flooded. This proved a test for the Armed Corps culverts. And now work nears the milestone pub. During April, we saw the first delivery of 12 pairs of steel beams. These were up to 40 metres long and they weighed up to 45 tonnes. Cleveland Bridge, based at Darlington, manufactured and erected 384 tonnes of steel bridge. The very first spans were erected on the 21st of April 2002 during a precision nighttime operation. This attracted much interest from local people, as the bridge was eventually taking shape and a dramatic firework display was seen in the night. The sections were finally guided into place by human muscle power. And daylight sees the completion of the spans bridging the railway. And the railway can now reopen for traffic. It was closed during the erection of these spans and a Midland Main Line unit there passes beneath them. And a far view from the crossing site. The second section involved bridging the gap between the railway and the river. Again, the sections lifted into place by the gigantic crane which was on site. The crane was capable of lifting 800 tons. Once again, muscle power is employed for final adjustments. The precision is a testament to the engineer's skills. You can see work now well clear of the railway line, as section by section, the structure takes shape. Once the 800-ton crane completed its work on the south bank, it had to be dismantled. It then followed quite a long detour to commence work on the north bank. The detour was necessitated by the sheer weight of the crane. And now, arrival on the North Bank, its detour complete, and to be erected all over again. On the 24th of April 2002, a very special visitor passed by. None other than the Flying Scotsman. We can now see work commencing on the north side. These spans somewhat shorter than the ones used on the south side. The tape measure's brought out. Final check. Thumbs up, it's okay. Thank you. We can catch some views of the new Dern Valley Leisure Centre, which opened on the 4th of May 2002. Again, another welcome addition to the facilities of the Dern Valley. All spans in place, excluding the river section. This is the delivery of the river section spans. And the local wildlife along the river continues about its business. During the erection of the river section of the bridge, a safety boat was brought into use. Clearly, as men were working over the water, the risk was there. A good view here of the old bridge as the safety boat works underneath. And the river sections are now brought into place. During this phase of the construction, the weather was not kind. And for the first time, a man could walk the whole length. And at last, the final span winched into place for the few final millimetres by human muscle power. A sense of relief all round. The cables are released from the crane. And local people were there to record the historic event. And the main bulk of the heavy bridge work is now completed. However, much remains to do in the approaches with highway realignment and construction. The whole road topography will soon be altered. Thank you. You can see the shuttering over the railway line. This shuttering is to prevent any materials or indeed workers from falling onto the railway line. Still much work to do before any vehicles can cross. The bridge has no surface. It cannot be reached by vehicles at this stage. So much highway realignment has to take place. This is the new roundabout on the south side. New street lighting units and associated cabling had to be installed. And now the essential tarmac work commences to actually build the road surface, which will carry thousands and thousands of vehicles. And the south side roundabout is now complete. Additional bank strengthening of the river continued and depth checks were carried out. And still the queues continued, but relief was shortly in sight. You can see the traffic queuing back here, all the way up Doncaster Road. Here's the limestone from Cadeby being tipped to strengthen the banks. Essential finishing touches, new footpaths, signage, road markings, bollards, street furniture, disabled access. Links for public transport. And final surfacing, soon to be completed. And sure enough, there's the black stuff laid over Bambury Bridge. The name Bambury Bridge was arrived at after a competition was organised by the South Yorkshire Times. Clearly the new bridge needed a name. By an overwhelming majority, the name Bambury Bridge was chosen. This was named after Father Donald Bambury. He was a parish priest appointed to St Albans, Denaby, Maine in 1979. Father Bambury was and still is immensely respected in the Denaby areas. He was born in 1922 at Ballylongford in Ireland. He was ordained a priest in 1947. One of Father Bambury's distinctions is to be awarded the territorial decoration for his long service with the territorial army. In March 1994 he was made a Freeman of Doncaster and became a Monsignor also in March 1994.
issue, first of all, to the Mayor of Doncaster, Martin Winter, who will start this morning's brief ceremony. Thank you.
Thank you very much, everybody. I really do think this is a fantastic day to be here, halfway between Mexborough and Denaby, and I think it's absolutely brilliant that so many people have turned out. We've waited a long time for this bridge, for all the hard work that they've put in. Unfortunately, Caroline can't be here because she's got parliamentary commitments this morning, but she sends her best wishes. So I'd like to thank the two MPs for all the hard work that they put in to getting this bridge. Obviously Doncaster Council supports all the local communities, and the bridge here today is another sign that we're supporting the communities of Conisbury, of Denaby and of Mexborough, and once again joining those communities together. I'd also like to thank South Yorkshire Times for holding the competition to name the bridge, and I'd like to thank Balfour Beatty for giving the competition prize of £100. Now I'm going to introduce Monsignor Donald Bambury, who shouldn't need any introduction to most people here. And welcome Donald this morning. And I've just had a few words with him. And I'd just like to highlight the fact that when they ran the competition, there was an absolutely overwhelming majority of people wanted to name the bridge after Monsignor Bambury. So I think that highlights how loved Donald is within these communities, all the sterling work that he's put in these communities in the 30 or so years that he's been here, his commitment and his love for the area. And many of you will remember Donald for the excessive work that he put in the 84-85 miners' strike. And I personally would like to thank Donald for all of that work. I'd also like to introduce Denise Williams. And we don't make a good team between us because Denise has got a broken arm and I've got an injured knee. So we've nearly got one good body between us, haven't we? But Denise is the competition winner for the naming of the bridge. And I'd like to thank everybody who took part in that competition. So without further ado, what I would like to do is I'd like to ask Monsignor Bambury and Denise Williams if they'll unveil the plaque first of all. And then we'll cut the ribbon. We'll have to take a few photographs when we cut the ribbon, but then I'd like to count it down from 5 to 1, and then we'll all start walking over the bridge, if that's all right. So if I ask Donald and Denise if they'll unveil the plaque to start with.
Get on quick, shall we?
So if we go to the ribbon cutting now, we'll have to take a few photographs of the ribbon cutting, but then I'd like to count down and we all walk across, if that's all right. So if I can ask Father Bambury if he'll walk across to the ribbon with Denise, and we'll get the ribbons cut.
Why I think, why should I be chosen, but so be it. Thank you all for coming. I hope that this bridge will bring prosperity and peace to the area. There are so many industrial estates, mostly to do with distribution, but I think you should be proud that this industrial estate down here is production. This was always a productive area. Denaby Pit, Chadby Pit, Manvers Pit, and the people that worked there. We think of them today with gratitude and with love. Thank you all for coming, and God bless you all.
Thank you very much, Father. I'm sure we all know that the reason why Father Bambury was selected was because everybody in Mexborough, Denaby and Conisbury love him dearly. So thank you very much, Father. I think there's only one thing to say now. Enough of the political speeches, and thank you very much, Father, and we'll just count it down now. If the people on this side, if we can walk that way, and the people on that side of the bridge can walk that way across to Mexborough. So if we all count it down, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, roll!
And so for a short time, the bridge is claimed by local people and local pedestrians. And then, a little later on, traffic crossed from the Denaby side. The first of many thousands upon thousands of vehicles that will use Bambury Bridge for many years to come.